Hello friends, today we'll continue with some more problems related on height and distance. Like some problem we have already seen on the basis on the height and distance, and the basic concepts that use in height and distance is the angle of elevation and the angle of depression. So on the basis of this concept we have actually solved many of the problems. Now we'll see some good problems related to height and distance, and with the help of angle of elevation and the angle of depression will solve these problems. So the first problem we'll see is, first write down the problem, that is a vertical tower stands on a horizontal plane, and it's surmounted by a vertical flag of height h. At a point on a plane the angle of elevation of the bottom and top of the flagstaff are alpha and beta respectively. So we have to prove that the height of tower is h tan alpha upon tan beta minus tan alpha. So in this question it is given that there is a vertical tower. So first what we'll do is first we'll make the diagram on the basis of the given information, and accordingly we'll try to solve the problem. So in the question it is given that there is a vertical tower and the flag is surmounted on this vertical tower, and height of the flag is given as h, small h, and from the point on the plane, like on the straight ground, from there's a point, and from that point the angle of elevation of the bottom of the flag and also the angle of elevation at the top of the flag are given as alpha and beta respectively. So angle of elevation at the bottom is given as alpha and the angle of elevation at the top of the flag is given as beta. So this is given in the question, and we have to prove that the height of the tower, that is this height. So accordingly take this height of the tower as capital H. So we have to prove that height of this tower, that is capital H, is equal to small h into tan alpha divided by tan beta minus tan alpha. So now how to solve this problem? As we have made this diagram, now it is easy for us to understand the question and accordingly solve the question. So if we see this diagram, like in this diagram if we mark these points as A, B, C and this point as D. So now if we see this triangle, that is A, B, D, in the triangle A, B, D, the angle of elevation in this triangle is formed as alpha. So accordingly we'll use the trigonometry identity or trigonometry ratios. So according to trigonometry ratios, tan alpha is equal to, tan alpha as we know is equal to perpendicular upon base, that is tan theta. So in this case the perpendicular is BD and the base is given as AB. So as AB, there is no length of AB is given, so we assume that the length of AB is equal to x meters. So accordingly we will write instead of BD and AB as h and x. So as we written down BD as h, as we have taken down BD as h, capital H, so we will take BD as capital H, and accordingly the length of AB we are taken as x. So this is the first equation that we have formed, that is tan alpha is equal to capital H upon x. Now accordingly we'll write down the information on the basis of angle of elevation beta. And now if we observe this triangle ABC, in this the angle of elevation is taken as beta, and again we'll note that 10 beta if we take, this will be equal to BC, that is perpendicular upon base, that is AB. So 10 beta is equal to BC upon AB, and BC we can take as capital H plus small h, because the length of BC in this diagram is actually, if we observe this diagram, is actually BD plus CD, where BD is capital H and CD is small h. So the length of BC is capital H plus small h divided by AB, and AB we are taken as x. So this is our second equation. Now on the basis of this information, or in the basis of this equation, we'll try to get the thing that we want to prove, that is capital H is equal to small h into 10 alpha upon 10 beta minus 10 alpha. So how to do is this. See, if you observe in the first and second equation, we actually require capital H, we require 10 alpha, we require 10 beta, and we require small h, but we don't require the x. So from the first equation, we'll put the value of x in the second equation. So if we observe from the first equation, from equation 1, if you observe, we get the value of x is equal to capital H upon 10 alpha, and we'll put this value of x in the second equation. So if we keep value of x in equation second, what we'll get is, we get as 10 beta is equal to capital H plus small h whole divided by x, and we know that x is equal to capital H divided by 10 alpha. So we have put the value of x in the equation second. Now we will try to solve it. If we so when we solve, we will get as 10 beta is equal to capital H plus small h and divided by, in the denominator part there is capital H divided by 10 alpha. So this 10 alpha will goes to the numerator part, and it will get multiplied with capital H plus small h, and this whole thing is divided by capital H. Now we'll cross multiply, and after cross multiplying we'll get as capital H into 10 beta is equal to, and in the RHS part we'll open this bracket, we'll get as capital H into 10 alpha plus small h into 10 alpha. So now what we'll do is, we'll take the capital H on one side of the equation and the small h on the other side. H 10 beta, and the RHS part there is H 10 alpha. So we'll take this H 10 alpha from RHS to LHS, and we'll get as H 10 beta minus H 10 alpha is equal to small h 10 alpha. So now we'll take H common from this LHS part, and we'll get as, in the bracket, 10 beta minus 10 alpha is equal to small h into 10 alpha, and from this we'll get capital H is equal to small h into 10 alpha whole divided by 10 beta minus 10 alpha. So this thing we have to prove in the beginning of the question, that capital H is equal to small h into 10 alpha upon 10 beta minus 10 alpha. So again, with the help of angle of elevation, we have solved this question. And most important thing in this type of question is, we have to make the correct diagram accordingly. So if you have made the correct diagram, it is very easy for us to understand the question and accordingly solve the question and prove whatever there is asked in the question. So now we'll move on to the next question. First we'll write down the question is, the angle of elevation of the top of a tower from two points at a distance A and B meters from base and in the same straight line with it are complementary. So we have to prove that height टावर इज इक्वल टू अंडर रूट ए इंटू बी मीटर्स. सो इन द क्वेश्चन इट इज गिवन दैट द एंगल ऑफ एलिवेशन ऑन टॉप ऑफ टावर फ्रॉम टू पॉइंट्स एट अ डिस्टेंस ऑफ ए एंड बी मीटर्स फ्रॉम बेस. इट मीन्स मीन्स वॉट इज फर्स्ट वी अकॉर्डिंगली मेक द डायग्राम फॉर दिस. सो फर्स्ट वी अंडरस्टैंड द स्टेटमेंट दैट इज गिवन दैट द एंगल ऑफ एलिवेशन ऑन टॉप ऑफ अ टावर from two points at a distance a and b meter from base. It means that there is a tower and from the base of this tower there is a they are given two distance, that is one is at a distance of a meters and other point that they are given is at a distance of b meters from the base. So accordingly they have given two points a and b and the angle of elevation from these two points that is a and b on the top of the tower are given as complementary. It means sum of these two angle of elevation, that is that the angle of elevation that the person is making from point A and the angle of elevation that a person is making from point B, the sum of these two angles is equal to 90 degree because it is given that both angles are that these two angles are complementary. It means their sum is 90 degree. So accordingly if we'll take this one angle as theta, so automatically the other angle will be 90 minus theta because both these angles are complementary and their sum is 90 degree. So and accordingly we have made the diagram and we'll try to solve it on the basis of given information. So what we have to prove finally is that the value that the length of this CD or the height of the tower. So we'll take a height of the tower as small h. So we have to prove that the height of the tower that is small h is equal to under root a into b. How to prove it is? So accordingly we have made the diagram. Now we'll try to write down the equation with the help of trigonometry ratios. So if you observe this triangle that is ADC, in this triangle if you observe that tan theta is again equal to perpendicular upon base, and in this case the perpendicular is small h and the base is a. So this is the first equation we have written, and now we'll observe the second triangle that is BDC. And if you observe the second triangle, on the basis of the second triangle we'll write down the second equation, that is tan 90 minus theta is equal to perpendicular, again in this case the perpendicular is CD, that is small h. And if we have taken this triangle BDC, in this case now the base is BD, and we know that BD is actually given as small b, that is the distance of this point B from the base of the tower. So this is the second information we got. Now we got the two information, and now we'll try to get the required thing, that is the thing we need to prove. So what we'll do is we'll multiply these two equations. So if we multiply these two equations, that is multiply equation 1 and 2. So if we multiply these two equations, what we'll get is tan theta into tan 90 minus theta is equal to h upon a into h upon b. So this thing we'll get after multiplying these two equations. And why actually we have multiplied is, the main reason is tan theta into tan 90 minus theta, and we know that tan 90 minus theta is actually equal to cot theta. So tan theta into cot theta will become 1. That's why we multiplied this equation, because the thing we need to prove, we don't want the tan theta or cot theta in that thing. So for removing tan theta and cot theta, we have multiplied these two equations, and after multiplying we'll get as tan theta into tan 90 minus theta, that is cot theta, is equal to, in the RHS part we'll get as h square upon ab. So this thing we'll get after multiplying the first and second equation. So as we know that tan theta is sin theta upon cos theta, and cot theta is cos theta upon sin theta. So it means that this whole thing will get cancelled and it will be equal to 1. So in the LHS part we'll get as 1, and in the RHS part we'll get as same thing, that is h square upon ab. And now we'll cross multiply it, we'll get as 1 into ab, that is ab is equal to h square. And now if we take the square root of ab to remove the power of h, so what we'll get is h is equal to under root ab. And this thing we have to prove in the beginning. So in this way we have solved the question, and accordingly and accordingly you will get the required result. So again, with the help of angle of elevation, angle of depression, we are solving the question, and most importantly we are making the diagram properly, and on the basis of that we will be able to solve the questions properly and correctly.